This figure shows the estimate of R star, or the neutral real interest rate, for a block of advanced economies that I estimate using a structural general equilibrium model in the recent Brookings paper. R star is estimated to start at about 5% in 1970s, then it increases sharply to over 7% towards the end of the decade, and then starts this continuous decline. This decline has gathered a lot of attention. It has been driven in part by demographic factors, in part by the slowdown in economic growth. But recently, long-term interest rates in the markets have increased substantially. And so that begs the question, are we at the turning point? Is it the end of an era of declining real interest rates? And are we going to see interest rates shooting back up? And so to assess this possibility, in the paper, I entertained six different scenarios. So these lines from 2025 onwards, they project six different scenarios where I quantify some of these popular narratives into their impact on R star. And so perhaps just picking on the AI scenario as one of the more interesting ones, this is a scenario where artificial intelligence boosts growth and leads to greater concentration and greater automation in the economy. All of that requires capital investment, which drives a rate of return upwards. And you can see quantitatively, this scenario is important and able to raise R star by 1 percentage point or so. Now, each of these individual scenarios embeds some of these bold assumptions and translates them into the impact for R star. One can then ask, you know, how likely is it that R star will rise to the levels last seen before the global financial crisis? And perhaps the answer to that is, well, it's possible, but maybe not very likely, because we get that increase shown here in the dashed line only when we combine all of these scenarios together. And perhaps that is not the most likely possibility that all of these risk scenarios are going to materialize all at once.